Women's inequality and exploitation can be seen in the street, school, workplace and everywhere else in the world. Even though in many cases this comes out as direct violence, the structural violence and the cultural violence hold them tight in an invisible manner. But especially for Sri Lankan women, what are the real challenges? So where they really comes from? These are important questions that need to be answered. Health, security, education, decreasing number of female political participation are some of the challenges for Sri Lankan women. But when we think critically, we can see the root cause lies in our basic social structure. Family is the basic organizing unit in Sri Lankan society, which is traditionally based on patriarchic male-dominated practice. So as the male character exerts power over both men and women, it has created a larger society which gives more importance to gender, rather human skills and potential. So the patriarchic society and the structural domination is the real challenge for Sri Lankan women. Also, every woman in Sri Lanka has experienced at least any kind of oppression or violence, as they confirm and moreover comfort the social structure. Also, the distinction between sex and gender has remained unattended in Sri Lankan discussion. I think the difference between biology and a social construct is a politically important discussion. If gender is a social construct, it can be changed. So it is not only for us, but to our region, a common enemy. Also, the common understandings and language which assumes the superiority of the male can be considered as another challenge for Sri Lankan women. It has forced Sri Lankan society to accept this common assumption. So women always, before everything they do, they tend to think what others expecting of me as a woman. So this has been the most ill-contagious question ever to represent the power relation. So understanding how social responsibilities and expectations lead us to perform gender is another big challenge for Sri Lankan women. So at the end, conforming to patriarchy always leads us to compromise claims to full freedom and perpetrates violence, and moreover keeps us resourceless and ignored. I thoroughly believe as a Sri Lankan, this practice need to be eradicated and rejected. As we are aware of the challenges, understanding opportunities and harnessing the collective potential to address those challenges comes next. Education is the biggest opportunity that we have. Education gives us critical tools to understand what it means to be the victim and the fragile relationship between the oppressor and the oppressed. So education considered to be the starting point of empowerment, and it has varied benefits ranging from health, self-defense, political participation, leadership, entrepreneurship, and to promote peace, democracy and good governance. As we have free education in Sri Lanka, it is indeed an opportunity for Sri Lankan girls. Almost every girl child in Sri Lanka has an equal opportunity to educate themselves. But the real question is quality of the education. What do we teach them? I think educating girl child on how the social responsibilities and expectations lead us to perform gender is an important lesson to be taught in a school. Also, the foundation attitudes of peace, equality, non-violence need to be planted in Sri Lankan education system. So the education we give to girls should be an enlightening experience for them. It should provide guidance to a greater freedom and a beginning to critical thinking. So where we can start? As an Asian woman, what is my responsibility? So the first is preparing our own selves for impactful leadership positions. We need to educate ourselves in every aspect. Also, think critically and act critically comes next. Behaving in a manner that conforms to the stereotypes I mentioned earlier gives women no freedom, no honor. It has a huge impact on us, especially on our girl child. So we should always work to seek for an end to women's exclusion from underrepresentation in power, office, employment, and education. Activism is another thing important. The first part of activism comes from us. Empowering our own selves as women leads us to fight collectively against violence and discrimination. So the next part is what we can ask for. We can ask for better opportunities to initiate change, increasing the number of women in political participation, stop considering gender as any type of qualification, are other things important. What Sri Lankans can do. We as Sri Lankans can empower women to overcome traditional barriers. As Sri Lankans, we need to understand that any form of oppression or violence on women is a call for solidarity, and it unites us in our search for ways to survive. So understand the challenges, think critically, find the opportunities to fight collectively. Thank you. I'm Ransi Karunaratna from Sri Lanka.